Good morning, everyone. Am I audible to you? Yes, okay. So, in last class, what did we study? Do you remember? So in last class we have studied about rapidly varied flow, hydraulic jump, isn't it? That one is complete, I think. Hydraulic jump.
Yes, ma'am.
And did I share the notes? All of you got the notes of hydraulic jump, RBF. I think I gave you, isn't it? I think I have said, so far I remember, I have said notes also. So today we are going to start the, I think that one is the last topic, that is a new one called computational fluid mechanics. Not computational fluid mechanics, computational fluid dynamics. And what is computational fluid dynamics? Let me share some content. So let me know you, is this visible to you or not? Is this visible? Okay, as soon as I have shared my screen, my meeting is gets automatically locked. Let me. Okay, let me unlock. So, what is computational fluid dynamics? Let's see. So, computational fluid mechanics, computational fluid dynamics. In short form, it is called CFD. Okay? So, CFD is a branch of fluid mechanics that uses numerical analysis and data structure. So it is basically a computerized problem to analyze and solve problems that involve fluid flows. Okay, so generally computational fluid dynamics is used to solve fluid related problems, and it is a computer based model. It is a model, actually it is a computer based and model. Okay, so computers are used to perform the calculations required to simulate the free stream flow of the fluid. And the interaction of the fluid with surfaces defined by boundary conditions. So there will be some boundary conditions. With high-speed supercomputers, better solutions can be achieved and are often required to solve the largest and most complex problems. Ongoing research yields software that improves accuracy and speed of complex simulation scenarios such as transonic and turbulent flows. Transonic and turbulent flows. Initial validation of such software is typically performed using particular problem can be used in comparison. A final validation is often performed using full-scale testing such as flight testing. So CFD is applied CFD is applied? CFD is applied to a wide range of research and engineering problems in many fields of study and industries, including aerodynamics, aerospace analysis, weather simulation, natural science, environmental engineering, industrial system design and analysis, biological engineering. What is biological engineering? It is the application of principles of biology and tools of engineering to create usable, tangible, economically viable products. Biological engineering employs knowledge and to form a number of pure applied science. So fluid flows, heat transfer, engine combustion analysis. So these are the field of engineering where we can apply CFD. Okay, so back history. The fundamental basis of almost all CFD problem is Navier-Stokes equation. Remember. So what is the fundamental equation of Navier CFD? It is the Navier-Stokes equation. The fundamental basis of almost all CFD problem is Navier-Stokes equation, which define many single phase fluid flows. These equations can be simplified by removing terms describing viscous action to yield Euler equation. Further simplification by removing terms which describes full potential equation. Finally, small subsonic and supersonic flows, these equations can be linearized. Historically, methods were first developed to solve the linearized potential equations. Two-dimensional 2D methods, conformal transformation of the flow about a cylinder with a flow about airfall, were developed in 1930s. So generally CFD is applied first in 1930. One of the earliest type of calculation resembling modern CFD are those by Lewis Fry Richardson, in the sense that calculations use finite differences and divided the physical space in shells. Although they failed dramatically, this called together the research and book weather prediction by numerical process set the basis of modern CFD and numerical meteorology. In fact, early CFD calculations during 1940s using ENIAC use method close to those of research and 1922 book. The computer power available Pace developed three-dimensional methods. Probably the first work using computer's model fluid is governed by Navier-Stokes equation, and is performed in Los Alamos National Lab. This lab is actually States Department of Energy during the World War II, designed for nuclear weapons as these are. So, okay, no need to study so much history. Okay, let me share some another screen. So let me share some video, then you will understand and it will be more interesting.
So the first question that is very common and very obvious that you have in mind is, what is EFT? So the analysis of practical fluid flow problems involves two fundamental approaches. Okay, so if you try to solve any practical fluid flow problems, we can use two approaches. One is experimentation and the second is the calculation. So experimentation requires the constructions of model which are tested in various facilities. One topic we have already said and read in this course was dimensional analysis. Dimensional analysis is very, very critical to this experimentation, because when we do the experiments in the lab, to be able to apply those in real life, we need to study dimensional analysis. And as it is written here, experimentation involves the construction of models which are tested in various facilities. Whereas calculation involves solution of differential equations. So whatever the differential equation of the problem that we form, that is the solution to that differential equation is called calculation. So this calculation can be performed in two ways. One is analytically, or the second is computational. Analytical is mathematical solution. For example, like you solve integral equation by hand using the formulas of math. Computational is using the computers. So the field of study devoted to the solution of the equation of fluid through the use of computers is called computational fluid dynamics, or CFD. Okay, so this is a very crude definition, but at your level we can say that the field of study devoted to solution of the equations of fluid flow through the use of computers is called computational fluid dynamics, or CFD. So the equations of fluid flow could be Euler equation, Bernoulli's equation. So they are in a broad sense termed as CFD, but in reality the solution of Navier-Stokes is called computational fluid dynamics, or CFD. C stands for computational, F stands for fluid, D stands for dynamics. All right. In this field of study called computational fluid dynamics, experimental results are used, and they're often used. And what is the purpose of using those experimental results? They're used for validation of the CFD solution. So if we get a computer based solution from the equations, we use computer to solve those equations, and we get some answers, results, how do we know if it is correct or not? So what we generally do is, we do the mathematical calculations for the same situation as one of the experiments had been done before. Either we do the experiment in the lab, or somebody else might have done. But beforehand, we know the experimental results of a situation. For the same situation, we do math computer based solution, and we try to check if the results that we have got from the computer is the same or very close to the experimental results or not. So this process is called validation. Validation means, so it will validate, it will justify, or this will say that okay, the CFD solution is okay or not. So if the code or the solution is successfully validated against experimental results or a real life field study, that process is called the validation of the CFD solution. So computational fluid dynamics can handle laminar flows with ease. It's not a problem at all. The problems become complicated when we have turbulent fluid flow. So the CFD solutions for turbulent flow situations are much more complex. All right. The accuracy of the turbulent CFD solutions depends on the appropriateness of the turbulence models. So you will later study in this module that there are something called turbulence model. Okay. Just to name them, one is, you know, K epsilon, K omega, there are different models. So these are called turbulence model. There is something called, which cannot be actually said turbulence model, but a different way of solving this technique is called large eddy simulation. There is something called direct numerical simulation. So the accuracy of these turbulent CFD calculation depends which model are we going to apply. We will see that direct numerical simulation gives the best results, most accurate results. Large eddy simulations give the second best results, and the last is Reynolds average Navier-Stokes equation. In Reynolds average Navier-Stokes equation, there are different turbulence modules, but everything comes with a cost. For example, you must just know that direct numerical simulation, although it has the best accuracy, but the time of computation that is required is extremely high. So large eddy simulation are the second best in terms of accuracy, but cost wise it is also very, very high, of course less than direct numerical simulation. Whereas Reynolds average Navier-Stokes equation has lesser accuracy than the above two, but the time of computation is far less than what these two type of models CFD takes. But we will come to those later as well. So this is what it means. The accuracy of the turbulent CFD solution depend upon the appropriateness of the turbulence model. Which turbulence model is appropriate? Now going to differential equations of the fluid flow. So the differential equations of fluid flow are, we have been going through this from a long time now. One is continuity equation that we have seen. For example, in compressible flow, del dot P is equal to 0. Alright. Which you have seen actually in the last week's model lectures on viscous fluid flow. And the second is the Navier-Stokes equation. So these are the two equations, differential equations of fluid flow. Alright. And the solution of these equations to computers is called CFD, computational fluid dynamics. So the aim of CFD is to seek the solution of these equations for practical flow situations under consideration. You remember when we started this lecture, we defined CFD, the use of computers to solve the fluid flow equation, right? So these are the fluid flow equation that we are talking about, all right? Continuity equation and the Navier-Stokes. And the aim of CFD is to seek the solution of these equations, and it should be for a practical flow situation. We should not assume say a velocity of 1 lakh meters per second or something like that. No, I mean the simulation should be very much practical in nature, like a velocity of 1 meter per second or a wave traveling with a wave height of 1 meter. If you assume a wave height of like 100 meters, it might not be very real, for example. All right. So for an incompressible flow of a Newtonian fluid, this is the continuity equation. Del dot V is equal to zero. And this is continuity equation or the conservation equation. All right. The second equation, if you can remember, what is this? Yes, this is Navier-Stokes equation, which is actually a transport equation, and this Navier-Stokes equation is for incompressible flow. All right, we want this one. So as I said, Navier-Stokes equation can be classified as transport equation, and continuity equation can be classified as conservation equation. So this transport equation transports what? It is a transport of linear momentum. All right. So for three-dimensional flow in Cartesian coordinates, there are four coupled differential equations involving four unknowns. So if there is a flow which is occurring in three dimension, there are four different equations, all right, which involves four unknowns. So one of the unknown will be the velocity in u direction, the other is going to be the velocity in v direction, and the third one is going to be velocity in w direction. Okay, all three directions are velocities, and the fourth one is going to be the pressure. All right, so these are the four unknown, as it's already written here, u, v, w and p. And if there are four equations, I mean there are four variables u, v, w and p, there are four coupled differential equations. So these are the four equations. So this is nothing but del dot v is equal to 0. As it is written, del u by del x plus del v by del y, del w by del z. So now you would understand why I taught the viscous fluid flow lecture before and we derived it everything, because this particular module CFD comprises of many equations, and it is it will help you a lot if you can recognize these equations. So now you can easily remember that this was equation of continuity. This one, rho del u del t plus u del u del x plus v del u del y plus w del u del z is equal to minus del p del x plus mu del u square by del x square plus rho gx. This is momentum in x direction. All right. Similarly, and this actually we have derived all these equations, right? We wrote it in a general form in terms of I and J, but if you write it in I, J and K separately, there is going to be three equations. Navier-Stokes equation, okay? Or incompressible. Or incompressible. Okay? So this is momentum in y direction, and this is momentum in z direction. All right. So CFD is the technique of obtaining the solution of these coupled differential equations using numerical methods. Okay. So we are refining the definition of CFD as we are going on. Initially we said that CFD is the computer solution of the flow equations. And flow equations can be many, right? Even Euler equation can be solution, I mean the flow equations. Then we went and said CFD is the technique of obtaining solutions for momentum and continuity equation. And now we say that these equations are coupled differential equations, and we solve it using which methods? Numerical methods. I am hopeful that in your BTech course you have studied a course called numerical methods in engineering, where the different techniques are taught. We will go through the basics of that, some of them in this module as well. So CFD involves replacing the partial differential equation, that is PDE, with discretized algebraic equation. Okay, that approximates the partial differential equation. For example, I mean, for example, if say there is dp by dx, so we have to replace it with, for example, delta p by delta x, or p2 minus p1 divided by some things like that. This is very basic to write, but I hope this will make it clear to you what is discretized algebraic equation. So this is like an algebraic equation, right? So CFD involves replacing the partial differential equations with discretized algebraic equations that approximate the partial differential equation. So that is why there was a approximate sign when I wrote those. All right. Now, what is the solution procedure? The solution procedure in general, any CFD problems involves the following steps. First is we have to define the geometry of the flow. All right. We have to discretize the domain. We will come to it, what defining the geometry is, what discretization of the domain is. And then there is a solver stage. Okay. And in the end, after the solution is solved, there is post-processing. Post-processing is after the results are obtained, we have to show it graphically, or we have to find some values. We have to interpret those results that we got. In most of the cases, plotting the results is termed as post-processing. So defining the geometry and the discretization of the domain, these two things are called pre-processing. So something that you have to do before the calculation can begin in the computer. All right. And the post processing is something that you have to do after the calculations have something to be done with the results after calculations have finished, whereas pre-processing steps to be completed before the calculation can begin also. Okay. So this is the general definition of pre-processing and post-processing. All right. So now, as you said, that the first step is defining the geometry. This step includes the creation of a CAD model. What is CAD? Computer aided design. Okay. So you use some softwares, or there are even tools available within the computational fluid dynamics models where you can define the geometry or derive. For example, there is a tank, right? And there is a pier, all right? And this is open I'm just drawing it in 2D, assume it is 3D, and flow is coming through this, right? So you will have to define this tank and this. Alright, so you can do it using the CAD models. Alright, and this is defining the geometry. So what does this CAD model do? The CAD model defines the shape and size of the domain in which the flow equations shall be solved. So what do? The CAD model define the shape. Say for example, as we said, it was rectangular in shape, right? And the size of the domain. So what the length of the, for example, length, what would be the water depth, for example, here. Water depth forming your depth of the tank actually, not the water depth. I'll drop this one. And also the width in 3D. The shape and the size of the domain. So for this is a CAD model for, you see this resembles the wing of an aeroplane, for example. Alright, and this has been taken from fetchdfd.com, that is why we have given a reference. Alright, so the second step was discretization of the domain. So this process is known as grid generation or mesh generation. Alright, so the process, this particular process of discretization involves developing a set of algebraic equations based on discrete points in the flow domain to be used in place of partial differential equations. We told that the way that it is to be done is to partial differential equations, we try to transform it into algebraic equations. So for that, for example, if this is a domain, we need to know, suppose we have to divide it, right? That is how we are going to write delta x. Right, we have to divide it in. So let's say we have divided so many different parts in x and y direction. So pardon drawing. Right. So the process of discretization involves developing a set of algebraic equation based on discrete points in the flow domain. So you know we will. So this is what meshing is. So we divide our domain into so many small parts. Okay, and these are helpful because then we can actually use of these points. The if you remember from your limits class, suppose del p del x can be approximated as p2 minus p1 divided by x2 minus x1, right? So this we always used to write limit delta x goes to 0, right? So this means that the grid should be as small as possible for this process to be done. With which process? That converting the partial differential equation into the algebraic form. Okay. So for example, if there is a flow u coming from this side, we have defined 1 point, 2 point, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 7. So RTI is the strength of vortex in the ith panel. ith TI plus 1. So this is the way that we do, and we have taken this figure from one from Young and Fish. Alright, so defining these points or forming those points using the help of computer is called the mesh generation. So the most common discretization techniques available for the numerical solution of partial differential equations are the finite difference method. The second is finite एलिमेंट मेथड एंड अनदर वन इज फाइनाइट वॉल्यूम मेथड. सी वी विल गो इनटू स्मॉल स्मॉल डिटेल्स ऑफ दिस सो दैट यू हैव अ ब्रॉडर आइडिया. यू विल नॉट बिकम एक्सपर्ट ओवरनाइट इन ऑल दीज टेक्निक्स बट विल गिव यू अ वेरी वेरी गुड अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड ओवरऑल अ होलिस्टिक पिक्चर ऑफ व्हाट कंप्यूटेशन डायनामिक्स. सो वी विल टच ब्रीफली ऑल ऑफ दीज टॉपिक्स. सो एज आई सेड दैट
So I think this lecture is you can understand, you can get the points. I think you have got a clear idea what is CFD, how it is applied, what are the mathematical formulas used, where it is used, isn't it? So the basic things of CFD you have to study for this CFD chapter. The basic things, that means the definition, application, importance, methods, the basic steps of computational fluid dynamics, only that thing is required. Okay, so one or two more classes I will take one two more extra classes in the next week, I think. So let me take the attendance. 35 student present. Okay, so thank you everyone. I'm going to end this meeting. Yes, I will give MCQ questions, but not today. Or you want to do today? Practice of MCQ question I will give you. Okay, in next class, I think. Or I can provide some links also in your WhatsApp. Okay, thank you.